Hey, what is good? It's your boy Sneed, and we got some Mud gameplay. We found a hot new play that we've been running. I'm going to have to break it down a little more for you guys once I lab it just a little bit more to see, make sure it beats all the coverage. But you'll see it in this. I go for big points. Offensive explosion. Me and Dante Culpepper, we're here. We're real. This is next-gen Madden. If you haven't, subscribe, follow me, Twitter, Twitch. Enjoy.
The 20 to the 22-yard line.
Come on, get him!
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
To throw here on first down. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. It's caught inside the 25. And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Henry Ruggs, 78 yards. And the Raiders have taken the early lead. Well, that's how they envisioned it, get the football to start the game and score.
And I don't know if that was scripted. Was it an audible? Is it just a play call that they had in their pocket? No matter what, they had the right call on against the right defense, and they end up in the end zone.
Here's Tate to return. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Stafford and the Lions now have it first and 10 at the 20. Now whistles and the Raiders are going to signal for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They'll fake the give. Now Stafford. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Antonio Gates, the veteran tight end, was the intended receiver. That'll bring up second down. Throwing again. Stafford. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Reggie Nelson. And down inside the red zone at the 19-yard line.
Oh, timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. And he's got the hook up to Ruggs. And the Raiders are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. The pickup goes for 13 and sets him up first and goal. Carry for the legend, it's Bo Jackson, and a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. They go option right on second and goal, and he's in. Touchdown, Raiders! Dante Culpepper keeping it himself from 5 yards out, and the Raiders able to extend that advantage. He hit him earlier in this first quarter with his arm. Now he does it with his legs.
Right now, he's one of those stat stuffers that you see on the basketball court. You know, the guy with points, rebounds, assists, steals. One with the arm, with the legs. Let's see if he can continue this pace.
And sending out the reminder that, yeah, look, I'm known for having an arm, but I can do it with the legs on occasion when I need to.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard
line. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Stafford throwing quickly, complete out wide. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one a gain of 20 and a first down. With these run pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
They'll run on first down. It's Bush. And he's able to carve out about six there, down to the 37. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
A six-yard pickup.
Off of play action. Here's Stafford. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Calvin Johnson, 37 yards. And the Lions have got it back to a one-score game. And partner, they found a gap there on the post pattern, and it was in the middle third of the field.
And that's really difficult to do, because ordinarily the safeties are back there to prevent that happening. But they found the opening and exploited it.
Now it's Patterson. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
The offense for Las Vegas about set to begin the drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that.
And under the Lions' pressure, he's brought down. John Randall dropping the hammer. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. 22 yards there, a first down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
They run on first down with Jackson. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Another Raiders first down. First and 10 at the 46-yard line.
Through one quarter, 14-7 our score.
Raiders 14, Lions 7.
Back to throw now on first down. That's caught by Jackson. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that is caught. Touchdown, Raiders. Cordarrelle Patterson, 43 yards. And the Raiders add on to their lead.
So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minutes. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
A 7-yard pickup brings up second and 3.
At the give, this is Bush. And he'll be limited to a short gain up to about the 34-yard line.
Reggie Nelson on the tackle. It's a gain of 3. Brings up third and
3. That's out to the left and complete. Nothing doing on that one. It'll be fourth down. Great job of tackling there to prevent the first down.
One of the toughest skills in football, open field tackling. A lot of times one-on-one against a shifty receiver. He got it done in a nice way that time.
And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on fourth down. They are going to go for it. It's Stafford. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And this is going to be incomplete. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Raiders with the football now in excellent field position. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. And he's got a first down as he's going to be taken down. But a very nice pickup there just in front of the two-minute warning.
First and 10 at the 18-yard line.
A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Not much there, only a yard.
Brings up second and 9 at the Lions' 16-yard line.
Second and 9 now. And he's wrapped up, taken down, back at the 25. John Randall able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Third down.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant.
I think that interception happened for two reasons. Quarterback gets outside the pocket and panics a little bit. And receiver doesn't make sure he's absolutely in an open spot. So there's a guy lurking, took the ball from
him. Yeah, so don't wave your arms, right, as a receiver if you're not wide open?
Got to know that you're open. Otherwise, just don't do it.
The drive starts with Reggie Bush. And he'll go down at the 26 following a gain of 6. From the 26, they'll line up on second and 4.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you...
Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off by the safety, Reg. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Second down, it's Bush. He's got the first down inside the 10, and he takes this one in for a Lions touchdown.
Reggie Bush. As the first half is winding down, and the Lions able to get this back within a touchdown. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now.
Makes the score Raiders 21, Lions 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Raiders take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Las Vegas offense ready to start this next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they...
He's got it at the 15! And he will score. Touchdown, Las Vegas. Cordarrelle Patterson in the final seconds of the first half. And the Raiders are able to strike quickly for six. Janikowski now for the point after. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14.
Lions 14.
So barring a touchback, this likely the final act of the half as the kick is away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men. The lane opens here. He's past the 30. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. It'll be Lions football to start the second half, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And a good return, able to get out across the 35 to the 36.
Lions take over first and 10.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
Fresh out of the locker room, they hit him with a gain of over 20. On first down. Bush. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. Play action. Stafford. On Stafford for the third time is intercepted. Ronnie Lott, the Hall of Famer, with a pick. 30. 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Raider defense delivers a score. The mistakes continuing to pile up, and it looked like they were going to be able to eat into that deficit. Instead, now the deficit is even larger.
Yeah, they were on a march with a chance to get back within a score, but now that deficit continues to grow.
Janikowski good with the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And he returns this to the 22.
Golden Tate on the return. The Lions take over.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end complete. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. 16 more on that one and another first down. So here's a first and 10 now in Raider territory, right at the 40. On the run, it's Bush. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love the blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D linemen to make the play.
And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll fake it. Now Stafford rolling to his left. He's going to fire one, corner of the end zone. The Raider defense strong on that one in coverage, and now it's fourth.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable, and that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they've brought the heat, and if he flushes out, they're fine with that, and they force another incompletion.
They snap it to Stafford. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Dominique Rogers-Cromartie. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Final minute now of the third quarter. Second and three. Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And Waller taking it in over the middle. And all the way down to the 7 yard line. So three plays, already first and goal, and they are wasting little time.
No let up in this passing game. They've been a well-oiled machine throughout. And I actually saw a few guys on the sidelines at the end of the third quarter doing the old hold up four fingers college sign, meaning the fourth quarter is ours. And they certainly weren't kidding.
They'll try to run it in, going option right. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Raider touchdown. Taking it in from 7 yards away. And the Raiders add 6 to their lead. That option pitch we saw, we don't witness a ton of that in the NFL, but it worked there down near the goal line for a score.
And it's actually a great call in goal line situations because as more and more quarterbacks enter the league with that mobility and having run option in college, more pro teams are adding it to their arsenal. And now it's not just does the quarterback run it, does he pitch it? Now they've added that third element. He can rise up and throw the ball as well.
Sebastian Janikowski set to kick.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. Take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot, great place to run something.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by the former USC man, Taylor Mays. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
And here's a throw that's taken in by the tight end, Cook. And he's taken down inside. inside the 30. That one good for 13 and a Raider first down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. That'll be complete to Cook. A gain of 6 there on first. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4. And this will be caught, and the carnage continues. It's another touchdown.
And that was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone, so give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Janikowski on for the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead.
Makes the score Raiders 49. Lions.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. Here's Tate to return. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30.
The Lions take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. Now, they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And he will be taken down deep in Las Vegas territory. A big play there for Detroit. 52 yards.
Well, partner, that's how you make a long drive suddenly not so long anymore. One big play, and they're already in field goal range with designs on getting more than that.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. They'll run it with Bush. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
First and goal at the 6-yard line.
Here's Stafford. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. 6-time Pro Bowler Calvin Johnson, the intended target. But it'll be second and goal.
We've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
And somewhat of a measure of revenge as he's in for the touchdown, but they still trail big time.
He'll take it, but he won't be able to smile about it.
Great call to hand that one off, and his running back did the rest.
Someone read their keys correctly. And on the defensive side of the ball, they certainly did not, because they really essentially were just going to...
Oh, and now they're going to fake it. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Let me go ahead and show my age a little bit. I liked it when they would fake it from the 3-yard line, right? When you'd line up, go ahead, and oh, there's a fake, and now he's going to get 2. That's great. But from the 15... The risk-reward, it's just not there.
So risky to get 15 yards on a fake. Well, you see the result right there.
Yeah, I know these young whippersnappers are trying to do different things in this game, but let's go back to old reliable. Kick the ball through the post.
Get off my lawn.
That's darn right.
The Raider offense set to get this drive started.
And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, In the 2015 season, I commentated on.
And that's caught inside the 30. And all the way down to the 26. A big play that time for the Raiders. 49 yards. Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete. Darren Waller, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up second down. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And give him another six. It's caught for a touchdown, and the blowout continues.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Now the Raider offense will stay out there as they'll line up to go for two. They'll look to throw again. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth.
57, Lions 20.
Now Janikowski following the score. He'll boot this one away. Here's Tate to return. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches.
And now here is another interception. Picked up by Nnamdi Asomugha. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. The utter domination here just continues. This defense, I don't know what more we can say all around about their performance.
Well, it certainly feels in this game like maybe they're facing a Canadian defense. 12 guys on the field.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked by Tracy Walker. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Lions touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football. Oh, and now they're going to fake it.
Okay, they went for the fake off of the extra point attempt. It's a long way to go, and they didn't get there, didn't get it completed successfully. Did someone dare them to do that? Did someone double dog dare him to do that?
I was going to ask you, maybe they saw something on film, but do you see something on film with those to try something from the 15 on a PAT? I don't know.
The only thing they needed to see on film there was a snap, a hold, and someone kicking the ball through the post.
Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.